Well, it's time to talk about this foul-mouthed fucker. So we are going to rank the Child's Play films from worst to best, similar with the Halloween ranking video. And there's 8 Child's Play films at the moment in time. So let's start this thing off with number 8. The original Child's Play. Only joking, it's Seed of Fuck, Seed of Shit, Seed of Chucky. Fuck this film, enough said, but I better talk about it. All the great things about this film. The comedy is forced, it's turned up to fucking too much and it's just awful. Characters are bad, the gore is over the top and it just doesn't fit this film because it's just shit. Glenn, whatever that's about, Glenda pissing his pants, all that. Chucky just jacking off into a thing to impregnate Jennifer Tilly. Just, I think I've said enough. The ending is just bad. Enough said, I think. There's literally nothing good about this film, so that's why it's the bottom of this franchise and the bottom of my list. Now, from here on out, all these films I can watch and have a blast. With all the horror slashers, like your Michaels, your Freddies, your Jasons, your Chuckies, your Screams. The most consistent franchise with the best films is the Child's Play series, apart from Seed of Chucky, Seed of Shit. I can watch all these films and have a good time. So in Halloween there was a 4 or 5 at the bottom I didn't like. When I do my Child's Play and Nightmare on Elm Street, there might be 2 or 3 at the bottoms I don't like. There's definitely more in Friday the 13th. Just hinted what I'm doing next. Whoops. But just Child's Play, all the films I really enjoy apart from Seed of Chucky. So fuck that film. Let's get into number 7. And number 7 is Child's Play 3. So Child's Play 3 takes place in a military base. Andy Barclay is grown up, training to defend himself in the army. I don't particularly like the setting of the setting of the army base, but this film does have some cool moments. Got a good kill with the crusher, the impactor, the guy gets trapped in there. Presto, you're dead, don't fuck with a Chuck. Some good comments coming from Child's Play 3, or quotes from Chucky. Some people think they're forced, but I personally like them and think they suit the film.
Don't fuck with the Chuck.
Just like the good old days.
Nothing like a strangulation to get the circulation going. Presto, you're dead.
The end fight in the massive pop-up carnival is fun. But yet again, some of the characters are generic. Andy Barclay's recasted. I wasn't a fan of that, but yeah, like, it's, yeah, I've put it here just because where else was it going to go? It was either going to be 7th or 6th, and I just couldn't decide, so I put it at 7th. I didn't really, the main reason I don't think I like this film is because of the army base setting. And I know it's trying something new, but personally for me, I'm not the biggest fan of it. Anyway, coming in at number 6, Cult of Chucky 2017 film, one of Tyler's favourite Child's Play films, I know for sure. And he's going to be upset that I've ranked it lower than Child's Play 2019, but sorry, Tyler. Cult of Chucky, similar to Seed, it's a bit of a weird film. Don Mancini going for the weird route, however, it's a lot better. The setting is quite cool. You feel really trapped in the asylum with people going insane. The comedy is really funny, like the three Chuckies running about, and I've never felt alive. Oh, you've been alive for about 2 minutes. And then they're like, one with the short hair gets to go kill Andy Barclay as he returned, which was cool. The gore in this film in Cult of Chucky is great. It's just the ending I didn't particularly like, with Tina just standing up and walking off. Chucky finally possessed her, and he did it really easily, where he spent the first like 3-4 films trying to do it and it hasn't worked, and like he said, he was trapped in Chucky's body, but then now he just knows how to do it and do it to 3 dolls walking around. So I appreciate that. I know you can't redo the same thing over and over again, but I feel like it took away from some of those first films. But nevertheless, Cult of Chucky, I can put it in, have a good time. Like I said, the setting's good, the gore is really good. One kill, which was when Tina, not Tina, is it Tina? I have completely forgot what her name is. The chick from Curse and Cult. This is embarrassing. Anyway, where she's just curb stomping the guy, the doctor, who's horrible to her. His face in with the high heels. It's just awesome stuff. So the gore really picks this one up. When also the girl's laying on the bed and the glass comes down. That's awesome. But overall, I do like this film. It's one near the bottom of the list, but you know, that just proves how higher up these other films are. So, number 6, Cult of Chucky. I have no fucking idea why I said Tina. Still ranting from Halloween 5, Nika. So there we go. Anyway, number 5 in this list is, drumroll please, Child's Play 2019. Now, when I went to see this film with the Unnamed production team, no one liked it. I was so upset. I really enjoyed Child's Play 2019. There was a few things that really fucking stood out which I didn't like, but overall I thought it was a good film. Different take on Andy Barclay. And it did something new. Like, it didn't just rip off the first film, which is going to be high on this list. It just rip off the first one. Tried something new with the technical side and of Chucky going wrong as an Alexa malfunction and the voodoo doll stuff. So you've got two universes where you can watch whatever you want. But I really enjoyed Child's Play 2019. I thought Andy Barclay was good, his mum was great, the kills were solid. I think the final scene at climax of the film in the toy shop was really good, and I really liked this film. Things bringing it down for me though, oh my god, Andy's friends are so generic and fucking shit. They just pissed me off and they annoyed me. And the second thing that really annoyed me, probably the thing that annoyed me the most, is when Chucky has that decapitated head of the stepfather who was cheating on him, and they don't just call the cops, they wrap it up in the wrapping paper. And I just, what? If I had a killer doll in my room and I woke up and there was a decapitated or just skinned face, I wouldn't wrap it up and throw it in a bin. I'd just call the fucking cops. But anyway, it's the film, he's got to carry on the plot and stuff. But apart from those two things, I did like and did enjoy Child's Play 2019. I think I watched it twice, so I'll probably have to watch it one more time to see where I really stand with it. But on my second viewing, on my first viewing, I've enjoyed it, so that's why number 5 is Child's Play 2019. Coming in at number 4 is Bride of Chucky, a really good Chucky film, and some people rank in the top 3, so well done, Bride of Chucky. You just missed out to your 4 for me. This is a really good film. This is where Chucky's at his funniest, I think. All the references to horror films. You had the Michael Myers mask and the hockey mask at the start. Tiffany's introduction and Jennifer Tilly as the Chucky doll, I thought it was really good. The kills in this film are solid. It's just a fun watch, just a really fun watch. But the one negative about this film are those fucking two characters you got to root through throughout the film. They're just, they get married even though they're accusing each other of murdering. And I thought, what are you doing? Why would you get married to someone you accuse them of murdering? But anyway, Bride of Chucky's really fun. You have that sex scene with Chucky and Tiffany, but that's kind of a funny sex scene. It's not over the top where it goes into see the fuck, which I've mentioned. But Bride of Chucky, really funny film, really good. You've got Chucky being at his best. Some good quotes like, it ain't the size that count, asshole, and rips the guy's thing out and suffocates him with a pillow. Overall, Bride of Chucky, just a phenomenal film. So that's why it's sitting comfortably at number 4. So coming in at number 3, we're in the top 3. It is Curse of Chucky. Oh my god, I remember when I first saw Curse of Chucky, I was so impressed. I absolutely love the haunted house style environment of it. I think the gore is solid, especially when that guy eats that rat poison and crashes his car, and then he obviously died, and his head just collapses off. Like, what? That is gruesome. You got Chucky, who's got a newish design but still looking good, and they actually show his former self when they peel off the clothes. Peel off the skin. Chucky in this film is good. Nika, really good protagonist to further the story on. Her parents and her people she's living with are dickheads, but Chucky fucking kills them, especially with the girl in the basement. She stabs her in the eye with a knife. Excellent stuff. Curse of Chucky, I think it's just one of the best Child's Play films, and I'll definitely have fun when watching it. Just the thing I didn't like about Curse of Chucky was how they tried to tie in Tina's mum with Chucky, so Charles Lee Ray, because you had the getaway car, but apparently no, now he's just running into the toy store. But I suppose they tried to connect some things up to make that story better, but you just got to brush over those stuff. But that's the only thing I majorly disliked in the film, and I was really excited for Cult of Chucky, but as you can see in the ranking of the list, it wasn't as good as Curse. So that's why Curse of Chucky, really good film, fun Chucky film, very good, is sitting at number 3. So, top 2, we've got Child's Play, the original, and Child's Play 2. Both amazing films, both definitely 4 to 4.5 out of 5 categories. But which is going to take the number 1 spot in my list, and which is my favourite Child's Play? Well, Chucky, we'll leave you down there, because number 2 is Child's Play, the original. Now, there's nothing to complain about this film, apart from just outdated, but yeah, again, you can't diss a film for being outdated, because at the time it was good. Some of the movements of Chucky, which were still impressive and really good in some scenes, like the mouth doesn't sync up to his speech, that's the only negative about this film. It's creepy, it's got some good classic horror things like the POV shot, and overall really good horror film. Put it in if I'm in a Chucky mood. 8 out of 9 times I'll put that in. I just absolutely love Child's Play, the original. You got Andy Barclay, such a good protagonist for this franchise. You got his mum, really good. Kills, not as many as in future of the franchise, but Chucky was just getting started. And he's violent, he's swearing, like when he's, "Talk to me, damn it, I'll throw you in the fire, you stupid bitch, you filthy slut," like all that stuff is just brilliant. And Chucky, that film definitely put up Chucky, Child's Play, being in my second favourite in the franchise.
I said talk to me, damn it, or else I'm gonna throw you in the fire!
You stupid bitch, you filthy slut! Did you fuck with me?
So Child's Play, the original, what a film, sitting at number 2. But just edging it is number 1, Child's Play 2. Now, Child's Play 2 is basically Child's Play, the original, but Chucky is kicked off. In the original, you had Chucky being a mystery. Is he the killer or is he not? You had Child's Play 2, had Chucky kicking off from the start, being a vowel mouth fucker since the first act, so he was just dominating. How's it hanging, Phil? All these fun quotes of Chucky.
How's it hanging, Phil?
The kills again are good. You've got the foster parents of Andy Barclay, as he's in foster care now because his mum's insane due to the first events of the film. And I think it would be if some doll, killer doll, was trying to kill you and your son. They were horrible characters, but then they got their demise. Well, not the mum, but the father was. He was a bit of a dickhead. You had Kyle. She was a really good protagonist, similar to Rachel in part 4 of Halloween, which really carried the film along. And had that awesome kill with the eyes going through the guy, splat. I think this film's almost 5 out of 5. I've got it at 4.5 at the moment, but you know, what, a few more watches and it could be up there. But I haven't even spoken about the final act in the toy store with that massive fight between Chucky and Andy and Kyle. Really good atmosphere, good setting, good prop design. Just the scores also is brilliant in Child's Play and Child's Play 2. And I just think Child's Play 2 is the pinnacle of the Child's Play franchise, and that's why it's sitting at number 1. Well, Chucky, we did it. We ranked all your films. Probably get some more films in the future and I'll update this list. Same with the Halloween franchise, but Child's Play 2 sits at number 1. Tell me what your favourite Child's Play films are, ranked from worst to best in the comments. Give a reason. And make sure to like, comment and subscribe for some more ranking videos. Up next, we're going camping to Camp Crystal Lake, where we're going to be ranking all the Friday the 13th films. So catch you there. Bye, guys.
I'm fucking infamous. I'm one of the most notorious slashers in history. And I don't want to give that up. I am Chucky, the killer doll. And I dig it.
Really?